Good morning, fans of Privateer FX. Looks like the dollar turned. Friday, it's going to be tricky. I do see the sort of macroeconomic backdrop as bullish dollars, but price is always most important, and it looks like we've turned. Have a look at these daily bars. Here's cable. We just made a new high here. 37. Here's Euro, another long legger. But keep in mind, this is a long legger within the range, so I'm not sure this is going to go astoundingly higher, but there will be topside pressure today in Euro and in cable. Downside pressure into Swissy. Dollar yen will also receive downside pressure, but less so. Look at that daily bar. It's bearish now. We've made a lower daily low, but much weaker than the other bars. Without bringing into the question, does this give us an opportunity to buy dollars at a better rate? Certainly in dollar yen, 111.60, massive support, and dollar Swiss, 99.90, also massive support. So those are your two areas of dollar buying, if that's your direction. We will not be trading that today. We're going to be core long cable. We got the UK Parliament voting on basically the economic outcome of Brexit. So they're basically voting on Prime Minister May's Brexit plan, which will decide how goods will be treated economically. So basically soft Brexit, hard Brexit. If they go soft Brexit, I think you're going to see cable flip over. I like cable as the vehicle also because this is the most obvious short. You know, last week the news was so bad out of the UK. Market's going to be short cable. So then you have this cable here. You want to be core short, and then you need your stop basically. It's a dollar Swiss chart. You need your stop basically above 132, the figure. So, I mean, actually, technically, this first support's 130, 190. So, you got to be flexible here. The obvious stop for the early players will be one below 132.25. Because it's a summer market, we kind of expect that to get done. But we're core long smalls from when we woke up this morning. And we'll play this with a stop below 131.90. One of the reasons we like it, Euro Sterling looks like it's about to flip. Just on the chart alone here, if you ignore the fact this is Euro Sterling, we would normally be selling here through 25, selling again through 20, selling again through 11, and then selling again through the figure. It's one of these charts that's been sideways for a long, long time. We've had a lot of strong moves higher, which have now failed. We're kind of right back where we all started. Here's the 4-hourly. Up, down, up, down, up, down, fail, 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 fail. Right here on this sort of pivoty area through 20, through 11, through the figure. Just so happens the 200-day moving average is at 18. This should help cable go higher. Also Sterling Swiss, much harder to trade. 131.60 looks like to be sort of a break trade. It's 132.57 now, so let's be careful of this. London's not even in for another 18 minutes. But anyway, all of these charts lead me to believe that Sterling's going to go higher today. So this is what we're looking at. This is what we're going to be trading. And voila, there we are. I will check in at the New York Open to see how everything went. And wish you guys good luck. Talk to you later. Ciao.